Welcome to the practical session. Today we are going to learn, do acids produce hydrogen ions in aqueous solution? In aqueous solution, or simply, dry HCl is not an acid because there are no H plus ions. We will do a lab activity related to that one. What are the materials needed? The materials needed is concentrated sulfuric acid. See this one. This is very dangerous. Okay, concentrated sulfuric acid. We must be very careful with acids, concentrated acids. The next one is sodium chloride. See this one. This is common salt, sodium chloride. Next, what is the third one required? Test tube or boiling tube. This is the test tube. Okay, next one. This is the delivery tube. Okay, from this delivery tube only the gas passes out. Next, see this one, blue litmus paper. See the blue litmus paper. These are the blue litmus papers. See this, the color is blue. Okay, blue litmus paper. Next one, look carefully, one hold rubber cork. Observe this one, this is the one hold rubber cork. Only one hole is there. See this one, one hold rubber cork. Look carefully. One hold rubber cork. Okay. What is the procedure we are going to follow? First, take the test tube. Hold the test tube with the test tube holder. This is the test tube holder. I am holding the test tube with the help of the test tube holder. Next, take few crystals of sodium chloride. This is sodium chloride. Okay, now what I am doing now, you observe this carefully. This is the concentrated acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. I am adding few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. Observe this one. What is the change that is taking place? See this. Some reaction is taking place. Observe it carefully. Now, you observe this one, from the delivery tube, some gas is evolved. Observe this one, some gas is evolving from the delivery tube. I am testing with the help of the blue litmus paper. See this one. I am testing with the help of the blue litmus paper. See this. Is there any change in its color? There is no change. Okay, do you find any change? Give me some water, one or two drops of water. Now listen to me. See this. See, do you find the fumes of HCl? Okay, what happened to the litmus paper? Do you find any change in it? What is the change? Red color. Actually, the gas produced during that reaction is HCl. Sodium chloride reacted with concentrated sulfuric acid to produce dry HCl. When you test the dry HCl with the help of the blue litmus paper, there is no change in the color. See this one. Once again, I am doing this. There is no change in the color. Okay? See, I am dipping in water. See this. See the change in the color. What is the color?
Red
color. Okay, blue litmus turns to red. Okay, with this we can say that in dry HCl there are no ions. Okay, dry HCl, there are no ions. When the litmus paper is wet, this HCl, hydrochloric acid gas produced, dissociates into concerned ions H plus and Cl minus. So with this experiment, we can conclude that for the dissociation of acids, water is needed. Dry HCl do not have any H plus ions because it doesn't turn the blue litmus. There is no change in the blue litmus. Okay, when we tested the same gas evolved with, see this one, with what is that? With wet litmus paper, observe this change. Okay, clearly it is turning to red. Observe this one. Okay, so this HCl in the presence of water molecules, in the presence of water or in the aqueous solutions, it dissociates as ions. Are you clear about that one? So what are the precautions to be taken during this experiment? We must be very careful while using concentrated acids. Are you clear about that one? Okay, next, you should check, there should not be the moisture around you. Okay, you have to conduct this experiment during hot day, okay, on a sunny day only. If it is cloudy, most of the atmosphere consists of water vapor. Okay, you didn't find this result. Okay, so moisture is present, this blue litmus paper turns to red. If you conduct the same experiment on a cloudy day, atmospheric water vapor reacts with this hydrochloric acid. Are you clear about that one? Okay, so for the dissociation of acid, okay, you need water. So HCl dissociates into ions in the presence of water. Are you clear about that one? So once again, what is the procedure we followed here? First, I have taken test tube. Okay, after that I have taken some salt, common salt. Next, I closed with the help of the one hole rubber cork. Next, I arranged a delivery tube. Okay, there is a reaction taking place between sodium chloride and sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. So this is the reaction which is taking place here. Here I am writing, see this one, sodium chloride reacted with concentrated sulfuric acid H2SO4 to give, what is that? HCl. HCl is a gas plus sodium sulfate, a salt, aqueous solution. Are you clear about that one? So NaCl plus H2SO4 gives rise HCl plus sodium sulfate. Is it balanced? We must be very careful. Okay, while writing the chemical equation, you have to balance it. See this one. How many hydrogens are there? One. Here two. So you multiply with two. Okay. Next, how many sodiums are there? Two. But here only one sodium is there. Multiply again with two. Now look carefully, check it. Two sodiums. Two chlorines. Two hydrogens, one sulfate, SO4. Now it is balanced. Okay, with this simple experiment, we can prove that acids produce hydrogen ions in aqueous solutions. Are you clear? Okay, any doubt in it? Okay, so we have to conduct this experiment on a sunny day, not on a cloudy day. Okay, if you conduct the experiment on a cloudy day, you didn't get the result. Okay, are you clear? Right.